गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज
पॉलिटिकल एंड सोशल लाइफ।
एज वी नो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अंडर दिस टॉपिक, एक्चुअली दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बुक्स इन आवर बेसिक थिंग्स। सो अंडर दिस टॉपिक Now we are studying Panchayati Raj. What is Panchayati Raj? As we know and you are all listening your life in Panchayat. That means there where you can imagine they have been ancient period when five people are organize and make a meeting and they can counsel for any matter, and if they are arguing and discussing for any important issues, after that they can reach about any decision. So this is a panchayat. That means minimum five people are discussing and take their decision after all those things. So in Panchayati Raj, according to our Indian Constitution, in directive principles of state policy, in directive principles,
Directive principles of state policy. This is a familiar of DPSP. In Article 36 to 51. Under Article 40. Under Article 40
provision has been laid down. The government will encourage and make a rule for the development of local self-government in states. So according to this foundation, in 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act 1992 in our Constitution has been made an amendment, and this amendment was came into force in 24th April 1993. Nowadays this date is familiar, Panchayat Divas or Panchayati Raj Divas. Day. According to this article, in 11th schedule, 11th schedule has been amended in our schedule in our Indian Constitution. As we know nowadays, 12th schedule Indian Constitution. In this is a provision of Panchayati Raj. According to this amendment, in Gram Sabha, the Article 243A it consists all the members of Gram Sabha who are attained the age of 18 years. They can cast their votes and they are a member of this council. This is a Gram Sabha. This is a council of village peoples. And next one is Gram Panchayat, as we discussed here. Gram Panchayat is a administrative authority and office bearer people. So where we can say Pradhan, we can say Sarpanch, and we can say village president. All are same. In different states, in different names are there. They are familiar. So first of all, I told you Gram Panchayat is a administrative body. This is office bearer. They have a president, vice president, secretary, and some ward members. Suppose that if any vast, if any very large area, 2 or 3 villages are there, so different wards are there, and they are a member of Gram Panchayat. And Gram Sabha is a Gram Sabha is a council. This is a council. They already, all the members of villages who attend the age of 18 years, sound mind, they can cast their votes and they are already member. And secretary is a government appointed person. They can call a meeting and they will recorded all those office proceedings who will vote of thanks or speaking president and all those members, they can make a record. The working of Gram Panchayat. What is the working of Gram Panchayat? What is their responsibility? The responsibility of Gram Panchayat is the construction and maintenance of water resources, water bodies, ponds, rivers, canals. They are observing all those things and they are superintending how they can flow, how they can maintain with accuracy. And water resources and road and drainage, how they can look the local roads, how they can adjoin the national highways. So this is their primary level responsibility, how they can maintain it. And drainage system, that is India drainage system is, we can say, is very poor because many people are not take care to other, because they have some lack of civic sense. And next one is school buildings, how they can literate their people. So it's very important because without the education, you can't aware to your day-to-day life. So it's very important. Without education, you can't do anything. And next one is common properties. Which is common properties? That's like you can say this is a natural resources. How they can preserve it? How they can maintain it? And next one is levying and collection of local taxes. They have to write, they impose tax for their local markets and they can collecting their money. This is a resources of fund collection. And next one is executing government schemes. Suppose that NREGA, National Rural Health Missions, and many Vridhavastha pension. So many types of schemes which taken by the central state government. The local level authority, that means this is a grassroots self-government illustration. So this is very important responsibility, how they can do it. And the next one is sources of funds of the for the panchayat. How they can collect their funds? What is the source? The source as all how they can source, how can they make money? Next one is collecting taxes on houses. They impose the house tax and they are responsible for collecting it, and marketplaces. And next one is government schemes received. Suppose that any government start with the pension, the state government responsibility, they can circulate their money, they disburse their money to all the respective gram panchayat, and gram panchayat with the help of secretary, they can distribute to all beneficiaries to their subsequent accounts. And next one is donations. Many charitable trusts and many high earning groups of peoples, they can donate some funds, and they can take the tax rebate in Article 80 CC. So this is earning of panchayati raj in panchayat, gram panchayat. And next one is the levels of panchayat. How many kinds of panchayat system in local self government? Then Article 243B, 243B. In Article 243B, there were three steps are there. As we know, first one is gram panchayat, as we know, village panchayat. Second, Kshetra panchayat. Kshetra panchayat. And third one is Jila panchayat. Jila panchayat. Article 243. There are three tier system are there. Gram panchayat, it's a village level. Kshetra panchayat is the block level. And Jila Panchayat is a district level. So, according to Panchayati Raj, actually, it's (clears throat) 243. It's a laid down article. 243 Panchayati Raj in our constitution, part 9. In our constitution, part 9, the elaborately laid down on there. So, Panchayati Raj in Article 243, Gram Sabha Article 243A, and Gram Panchayat Article 40. So, it's very important how we can get benefited whenever we are aware to all those things. So let's conclude our topic. Okay, thank you. We will meet soon. Thank you.